If you've got some unanswered questions about PDM or product data management software, I get it. Helpful though the software might be, it hasn't exactly got the most informative name. I mean, are the products physical, digital, both? What data are we talking about? Because there's loads of different types of data out there. What exactly do we mean by management, for that matter? Managing data could be just storing it, could be editing it, could be encrypting it, or sharing it, or all of these, or none of these. Honestly, the name really doesn't tell you all that much. This video, on the other hand, is going to tell you what you need to know. Since we work with hundreds of businesses who all deal with different data and information, we've got a pretty good handle on how best to manage that data. And after seeing how many unanswered questions people had about PDM, well, we figured it was time to set the record straight. Mikey with Plytix here, and over the next few minutes, I'm going to take you through what this software is, what kind of data it deals with, who normally uses it, and why. All so that you can figure out if it's the right choice for your business. Like always, feel free to skip ahead using the chapter links down below. I'll meet you there. Right, the basics. Product data management software is essentially a tool to help store, check, and share information related to product design and engineering. It does this by giving you a central hub for all your technical product-related data, and in doing so, it makes that data easily accessible to everyone involved in the product's lifecycle, from design through to distribution. It has features for managing complex files, as we'll see in the next section, and change orders, aka documentation packages with all the details of any proposed changes to your products and their manufacturing process. It also has tools to help make sure that all changes that do go through are tracked and documented to avoid any data loss or miscommunication. It can also integrate with other systems like ERP tools, e-commerce platforms, or product information management software to guarantee consistent data across all the different stages of a product's development. Don't get confused here, by the way. Despite their very similar sounding names, product data management software and product information management, or PIM software, are not the same thing. While they do work in similar ways and have similar benefits, they focus on different types of data. PDM is all about design, engineering, and technical stuff, but PIM is more centered on the e-commerce side of things. So marketing material, the product information for the different places you sell on, and anything else to help boost your sales. We have more resources available that get deeper into the difference. Just check the links in the description. Okay, so what exact data does PDM software deal with? Well, its main focus is design and engineering data, so stuff like CAD files, technical specifications, and manufacturing requirements. Some typical information that you can manage with PDM includes brand names, part numbers, part descriptions, supplier or vendor details, including part numbers and descriptions used by those suppliers and vendors, units of measure, costs and prices, schematics or computer-aided design models, also known as CAD, and material data sheets. This software can also be used to generate, store, and share bills of materials. These are files containing all the technical details we've just mentioned for one particular product or service. And they can be in various different formats, from simple spreadsheets full of alphanumeric data to more graphic-based files showing product diagrams in a clearer layout. Getting all that information into one file like this is useful for various reasons, but especially when it comes to sharing that information with anyone who needs it using the software's export functions. PDM software can be a great help for any company involved in production or manufacturing. It's traditionally been used by companies that produce physical products in particular, since it has a lot of features that help with engineering, design, and manufacturing. However, there are now also companies that work with non-physical products that use it too, such as some software development or service-related companies. And you'll see how and why when we get into the benefits of PDM in just a minute. First though, let's see which departments use this software within a given company. As you might expect, the most typical PDM users have traditionally been engineers, designers, and manufacturing personnel, since they're the ones who work most closely with this kind of technical data. However, since one of the main points of PDM software is to help with collaboration between different users and different departments, it's not unusual to see people from other areas using the system too, including project managers, administrators, or even people working in sales or marketing, purchasing, shipping, or finance. Sharing access to the software like this means people who might have been left out of the early project phases before are now able to give their input on product design and development much more easily, which is a pretty big plus. On that note, let's discuss some more PDM pluses. Any kind of software that helps with centralization and data sharing can benefit a company in numerous ways. But for PDM tools, there are some key points that make it super helpful for product development and management in particular. Firstly, like I said, it's a massive help for cross-department collaboration, since it provides a single source of truth for technical product data. This means that no matter their department, everyone from design and engineering to sales and marketing to finance and purchasing will have access to the same up-to-date information. This massively reduces the risk of errors and miscommunications that can happen when teams work in silos. Then we have features like version control and audit trails, which mean that any changes to documents and designs are tracked, and tracked well. In addition to providing a record of who did what and when, this can also give users valuable insights into how a product's design has evolved over time, whether it's a physical product or something non-physical like software. On top of that, PDM software supports regulatory compliance by helping keep all product-related documentation in line with industry standards and regulations. This is particularly important for companies in the healthcare, aerospace, and automotive sectors, or any other sector with extra strict rules that mean companies have to comply with specific regulations. Finally, if users can integrate their PDM software with the other tools in their tech stack, like ERP systems, PIM solutions, and e-commerce platforms, then data sharing and collaboration can get even easier. Automatic integrations and updates mean when all those departments I mentioned earlier need a particular bit of engineering or design data, they don't even have to go into the PDM software to get it. It's already synced with whatever other tools they're using. Let's look at an example so you can see what I mean. Imagine you're in the e-commerce team and therefore using PIM software to publish your products on your website. Part of the information you need to include would be the technical details, right? If your PDM software is integrated with your PIM software, you'll already have that information in your lovely familiar PIM tool. No need to jump between different systems, which makes everything way more efficient. Okay, one final suggestion. If you found this information helpful and are in the process of figuring out how PDM or another software solution might help with different aspects of your company's product data, then it's also worth looking into the differences between PDM, Product Lifecycle Management, PLM, and Product Information Management, or PIM software. In the end, understanding these differences is what's going to let you make an informed decision about how to put together the best tech stack for your company. So be sure to check out our resources on exactly that topic down in the description. They're packed full of the insights you need. Anyway, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you never miss out on our latest content. Companies.